Okay, Toxic Avengers, accumulate. I'd like to call this meeting to order. First, I would like to thank Admiral Murica for his tireless work to remove all the asbestos from the cafeteria. Job well done, soldier. However, Bulk, I hear you caused substantial damage on our last field mission.
Bulk just trying to save peoples from killer robot peoples.
That doesn't explain the devouring of every bagel and donut shop in Brooklyn.
Oh, Bulk, sorry.
Go fix it.
Bulk just really like donuts and bagels.
I have arrived. The meeting can start now.
The meeting started 5 minutes ago, as scheduled.
Hey, relax, Black Meadow. Let Leadman come sit next to you. You'll feel better about this in no time.
Yeah, about that Leadman. We're gonna have to do something about that. Lead is toxic to the humans you are saving.
What? No way, Eye Patch. This is my lead suit. The ladies dig it. Hey, it protects me. I don't have to worry about x-rays or nuclear radiation. How can it hurt those humans?
I'm sorry. I didn't create the laws of the universe. You need to work with Professor Plumbum here to recreate the newer, safer version of yourself. Further instructions are on your ship.
Hey, I'll show this Professor Plumbum that I'm fine just the way I am. Leadman ain't gonna change. No, sir.
This message will self-destruct in 10 seconds.
I don't want to go to some museum to find a flower painting. Are you kidding me? I'm a superhero. Flowers? Ugh. Ha! I wasn't even singed by that. Go lead powers. Those flowers sure are pretty.
Yes, there are 82 of them. All are deadly.
They're flowers.
They are made of lead.
Oh yeah, I hear there's a lead problem. I'm Lead Man.
I'm Professor Plumbum.
Professor Plumbum in the library with a lead pipe.
That was Professor Plum. I am Professor Plumbum. The lead pipes are involved in lead poisoning.
I'm confused. Poisoning? Lead? No. I'm the medicine you need, baby.
That's not surprising that you're confused. Look, Leadman, this is serious for both of us. We have to recreate you. You cannot continue to contact the humans in your current condition.
What do you mean? Look at this suit! Isn't it amazing? You can't mess with perfection.
Let's start at the beginning.
Okay, where are we now?
We're on the periodic table of elements.
I thought I was supposed to have the superpowers.
Lead is element number 82, with the symbol PB. It's a soft, silver-bluish metal that quickly turns to a black color when exposed to air. Lead is a very useful metal because...
Number one, it has a low melting point.
Melting point is the temperature at which a solid melts to a liquid.
Lead can be melted into a liquid at much lower temperatures than other metals. And then made it to the desired shape. So I better knock it off with the fire soon. Number two, it is malleable.
That is, easy to form into different shapes.
I can be flat like aluminum foil. I can be long and thin like a pipe. Or I can be round like a ball. Any shape, really. Number three, lead is also very stable over time and resists corrosion.
The gradual wearing away by reacting with other chemicals it's exposed to.
I am Leadman! Lead is great!
These properties have made lead very useful to mankind throughout history, to its detriment, as we'll see in a bit. Elemental lead, lead just by itself, is extremely rare in nature. Lead compounds, mixtures of lead and other elements, are found in the Earth's crust, the part that we can walk on, and are still rare.
Oh yeah, I'm a rare bird. So why is it a problem to humans if it's so rare, like me?
Lead is one of the easiest metals to separate from other metals in compounds mined out of the Earth's crust. Archaeological research has identified lead mines dating back to 6,000 years ago. Even before these mines, lead compounds were used by ancient peoples. Lead sulfate, a black compound, was used as eyeliner in the Stone Age. Lead oxide, yellow and red in color, was used to glaze pottery in 5000 BC, and pure lead figurines have been excavated from Egyptian ruins dating to 4000 BC, along with weights, vessels, and other metalwork. Lead coins have been found dating to 3500 BC from both Assyria and China. Romans took lead use to new depths. With the manpower to extract pure lead from mines and great engineering, the Romans used lead pipes in their aqueducts, water bridges, to deliver waters to the city. Remember lead's chemical symbol? It's PB. The Latin word for lead was plumbum, and the modern word plumber comes from this word.
Well, that really means you're lead woman. Don't fill yourself with hate for lead. You need to be more malleable.
Lead is sometimes called the Roman metal. They used lead in all facets of their lives, from curse tablets, sheets and bath, to lead compounds in their makeup and paint products as well.
See, the Roman Empire glorified lead, and nothing bad ever happened to them. You can't have too much lead.
In addition to the pipes, most households had pots and drinking vessels made from lead. Lead and its compounds have a sweet taste. The Romans used lead acetate as a food seasoning and as a wine preservative. They also concentrated grape juice into syrup by boiling it in lead pots. The acid from the juice would have caused lead to leach into the syrup.
So the humans liked lead. It was easy to work with. They used it everywhere. How cool is that?
One small problem. Lead and its compounds are toxic to humans and other animals on Earth.
Yeah, toxic. What's that mean?
Toxic means poisonous. A substance causing or capable of causing death or illness if taken into the body. Well, crying isn't going to help your toxic little problem.
Fine. How does it get in?
There are three ways things can be taken in or absorbed by the human body. Number one, through their skin when they touch things. Number two, through their stomachs and intestines when they eat. And number three, through their lungs when they breathe.
Well, I thought those things protected the humans, like my lead suit protects me.
That's true for many things, but each of these is made up of living cells. These cells absorb things from the environment and the bloodstream. The lung and intestinal cells will also absorb the lead.
What about the skin? Isn't that stuff dead?
The skin cells are truly more protective cells, and in the case of lead, do not absorb much lead. Just touching a lead object is not going to poison the human.
What about eating it? That sounds bad.
Once eaten, 20 to 50% of the lead eaten will be absorbed into the bloodstream of the human. Breathing it is worse. Of the lead breathed in from the air, nearly 100% of the lead is absorbed into the bloodstream.
Whoa, what does that mean?
All right. If there were 10 grams of lead in the room with you, and you ate it, you would absorb 2 to 5 grams of the lead into your bloodstream. If you breathed it in, nearly all 10 grams of the lead would be absorbed into your bloodstream. The dose was the same, 10 grams, but the amount in the body is different because of how it was taken in. Another important point, children absorb more than adults.
So now it's in their blood. How does it poison them?
Once in the bloodstream, the lead can travel to all parts of the body. It has different effects depending upon which organ of the body it is affecting. The primary target is the nervous system. When lead is absorbed by the cells of the brain, it causes permanent damage, including decreased intelligence, memory loss, paralysis, and decreased social skills.
Hey, we're talking about humans here. Lead doesn't affect my species. But why does it target the human brain?
The brain is sensitive to lead. A tiny amount causes big problems. Other cells can handle the lead a little bit better.
Give me the rest of it. What else does it do?
In the guts, lead poisoning causes cramping, pain, and constipation. In the blood itself, there are low levels of healthy red blood cells, the ones that transport oxygen to all the cells of the body. Poisoned humans also show reduced appetite and feel tired. It damages cells everywhere. In the lungs, the kidneys, and the reproductive system.
How much does it take to poison a human?
There is no safe dosage of lead. A high dose all at once results in acute lead poisoning, with symptoms affecting the neurological and digestive systems the most. Long-term exposure to lower doses results in chronic lead poisoning. The cells are being damaged all over, but at a slower rate, so the human doesn't appear to be poisoned because it happens over a long time. Even the Romans knew about acute lead poisoning from observing their miners, painters, and metal workers coming down with a disease. They didn't know about the chronic poisoning, though.
So the Romans stopped using it, right? Right?
Do you always follow the speed limit in your spaceship? Knowing about the dangers and not engaging in them are two different things.
And where are we now?
The Dark Ages, of course. Lead mining and use were much lower during this time period, up until the 19th century. One notable exception was the mechanical movable type printing press. Gutenberg combined several existing technologies to create this press that used lead-based printing blocks. Lead was melted with tin and antimony and poured into molds to form the printing blocks. Lead was also used to make bullets and weights for fishing. Remember, lead can be melted over a regular wood fire and then melded into the desired shape.
Those workers don't look so good. I thought lead wasn't absorbed well through the skin.
That's true. The danger comes from breathing the dust coming off the items as they are handled or heated, and eating small amounts from your hands and lips if they are not washed off after working with the metal.
So humans are sickened by me because of small amounts of lead dust coming off of me? That can't be true. I use a dandruff-reducing shampoo.
Yes, the lead dust coming off of you is a possibility for the sickness that could happen. That's why we have to recreate you.
Where are we now?
Focus. We're in the 1800s.
Ah, so when are we now? I thought I was the superhero. Hey, I want one of these time buttons you have here.
Focus. Focus! The Industrial Revolution brought with it mining at levels never seen before. Lead was easily accessed and cheap, with many industrial uses. Just as in Roman times, people used it for pipes or to connect copper pipes together. As in Roman times, usually as long as the water is flowing, very little lead from the pipes gets into the water. One of the largest problems of modern times came with the use of lead carbonate, which looks like this. It was used to produce bright white color in indoor house paints, just as artists before had prized lead carbonate for the same quality. Lead-based paint was used to paint virtually all indoor spaces, beginning in the 1800s until the 1950s, before completely phasing out by about 1977 in the United States. This paint is toxic when eaten.
Wait, who's eating paint?
Remember how the Romans used lead acetate as seasoning on their food? Lead tastes sweet to humans. Young children may find paint chips on the floor, eat them, and then look for more. People of all ages may possibly breathe in the paint dust as well.
Wait, hold it. So now the humans are surrounded by lead in their houses?
In a way, but it gets worse.
They're surrounded by it, drink it, and eat it. How does it get worse?
Henry Ford changed the world with the creation of the first moving assembly line car, the Model T. This made cars affordable to working families, not just the very rich. The other car companies quickly moved to copy the assembly line and make money selling cars to everyone. Competitors developed fancier cars, but their engines had problems. Engineers found adding a lead compound, tetraethyl lead, fixed the engine's problems.
Okay, but correct me if I'm wrong, I don't think people on this planet eat cars.
Tetraethyl lead is also known as TEL, and these TEL additives are extremely toxic to produce, and car exhaust emitted the lead product directly into the atmosphere. Remember, the body absorbs up to 100% of the lead that is breathed in, so inhaling a low dose of lead will cause more problems than eating the same dose of lead. It then causes all those health problems we talked about earlier.
Well, this is not looking good for the humans at all.
Calm down. There is good news. The toxic effects were recognized and legislation was passed to phase out TEL additives starting in 1973 and ending in 1986 in the U.S. All leaded gas additives were banned in the U.S. by the end of 1995. Most countries today ban leaded gas for automobiles. The levels of lead in the human bloodstream dropped by 78% from 1978 to 1991, after leaded gas was phased out.
What about those lead pencils humans use? What's up with that?
So-called lead pencils actually use graphite, a form of carbon that is non-toxic to humans. It has its name because originally they thought graphite was a form of lead.
Oh. Bummer. I told this girl one time that I made the pencil. Ugh, I gotta make a call. So, where does that leave the humans today?
Lead paint may be found in buildings built before 1978, but it is safe if it is not peeling or powdery. Similarly, some houses contain lead pipes. Leaded fuel is banned in most countries, and there is reduced lead pollution in the air. Lead is still used for many industrial processes and products, and lead mining and other industries continue to expose workers and communities to airborne lead. The two main uses today are lead-based car batteries and X-ray and radiation protection. Other uses include bullets and other ammunition, use in glass and ceramics, metal molds, sheet lead,
used in buildings, roofs, to surround cables, and sometimes it gets included in jewelry, paint on toys, cars, houses, etc., homeopathic medicine, fishing equipment, candy, remember the sweet taste, and metal decorations.
So what did we learn today?
The very qualities that make lead so useful to humans also make it extremely deadly.
Exactly! Acute lead poisoning by mining, painting, plumbing, and using the printing press was known in ancient times. The effects of chronic lead poisoning by the use of lead pipes, vessels, paint, and other lead compounds over a lifetime was only described in recent times.
Researchers continue to study the levels of lead and to support legislation to protect humans and the planet Earth.
With some simple precautions, humans can limit their exposure to lead in their daily lives.
So humans, protect yourselves from lead. Number one, don't play by old paint. You can eat it or inhale it. Don't let young children touch or play with it either. Also, don't play in the dirt. That may be contaminated with old paint. And it's gross. It's gross. Stop it.
And number two, flush old pipes with cold water for 30 seconds if the water is being used for drinking or eating. This allows any lead that may have come off the pipes into the water to flow out of the pipe and into the drain. Water that is flowing through the pipes, not sitting in them, is very unlikely to be contaminated with lead.
Number three, use caution when buying kid jewelry or toys or even candy manufactured in countries that do not have strict laws on the use of lead. Look for lead-free or non-toxic labels. Different countries have different laws on lead and its use.
Number four, thoroughly wash your hands after handling any lead solids. After science class, hunting, fishing, painting, or handling pipes.
Number five, recycle car batteries. Limit the amount of lead that gets into your local ecosystem. And number six, don't go to my apartment right now. I have a lot of cleaning to do, apparently. I've learned a lot today. Don't come by. We're going to move the party to next weekend, ladies.
Anything else?
Yeah, humans, wash your hands before eating or drinking. Leave your shoes at the front door. Don't wear a lead suit all the time. It's okay for your dentist to put one on for x-rays. The lead in those aprons is completely contained and can't leak out.
Knowledge is power. In this case, protective power. Lead man!
Yeah, no, that's uranium-plutonium fusion man now. Thank you.
Aw, man.
This has been a presentation of the U.S. National Library and Medicine Division of Specialized Information Services. Visit the Environmental Health Student Portal for more information on lead. Dismiss, soldier!